Bohr's quantization condition. After the Rutherford atom model, there will be some limitations we are found in the Rutherford atom model. That means the stability of the atom. The stability of the atom is not detailedly explained by Rutherford because the revolving electron will loses the energy. So finally, what will happen? Due to the electrostatic attraction of the nucleus with the electron may fall onto the nucleus, but that is not actually happens. So the scientist says that the Rutherford atom model cannot able to explain clearly about the stability of the atom. After that, the Bohr gives some proposal. So he says that the Bohr's quantization condition with the help of de Broglie wavelength. So what he says that when what is the de Broglie wavelength? The de Broglie waves is a wave associated with moving particle. So the any particle having the wavelength, any particle which has a mass m which is moved with the velocity v, then h by the momentum is equal to the wavelength of that particular moving particle body. So that is a wave associated with the moving particle is equal to lambda, which is equal to h by the momentum of the particle, that is mass into velocity. So the electrons are revolving around the nucleus, that is the statement given by Rutherford. So Bohr catch that point. So he is this that whenever any body is moving, there will be a waves associated with that. Also, similarly, here the electrons are revolving around the nucleus, so there will be some fixed orbit. In that fixed orbit only the particular electrons will revolving around the nucleus. So how that particular orbit can be fixed? In certain electrons will have the wavelength 1 lambda wavelength, that is a de Broglie wavelength 1 lambda. Certain electrons has a wavelength 2 lambda. So likewise it will goes on, okay, n lambda. So clearly whenever the electrons revolving around the nucleus, there will be a motion of electrons. If there is a mass of the electron m and velocity of the electron v, we can take in that by doing this calculation we get lambda 1. Similarly, certain electrons have the different lambdas. So he found that those electrons having the wavelength 1 lambda, de Broglie wavelength, by using this formula h by mv, v is the velocity of the electron revolving around the orbit, m is the mass of the electron, h is the Planck's constant. By substituting these things, he found that thus in certain electrons only having the 1 lambda value. That 1 lambda value electrons only revolving around the nucleus in the first orbit. How many electrons are there in the first orbit? Only 2 electrons. So in any atoms, only 2 electrons having, the number of electrons may be more. Even the uranium, it is more than 235 or all those things. But the only 2 electrons having the wavelength 1 lambda. Only 8 electrons having the wavelength 2 lambda. Only 18 electrons having the wavelength 3 lambda. So he found that certain number of electrons only having the particular lambda value. He found that if there is an electron having the 1 lambda value, that will be revolving only in the first orbit. If the electrons having the wavelength 2 lambda, that will be revolving around in the second orbit. If the wavelength has a 3 lambda, that will be revolving around in the third orbit. So he says that. So lambda means, so it will be exactly fixed. If you take that, this is a 1 lambda, this is a 1.5 lambda. So if you take that, what will happen? This is a upper, lower, then again what will happen? Like this only completed. So if we need to, this is this part. So this part are equal. This part and this part are equal. Again, this part and this part are equal. Are you able to understand? So I draw the black color is a de Broglie wave and this red color is a actual radius of the orbit. So this is the de Broglie wave, this one. So this is the de Broglie wave, this one. Again this de Broglie wave, this one. So the orbit does not complete. So what will happen? Definitely those electron having the wavelength like this. Okay, so that means it is completed. So that is a one wave. One wave is the upper half is a half circle and another half is a second half circle. So completely we get one circle. Okay. So we get one circle. Similarly, here we have the two upper half circle, two lower half circle. So 1, 2, 3, 4. Again, I will draw students. This is the upper half cycle 1. So this is the first one. Okay. Again, this one is a 2. You taken that. So 2 is here. So this will be equivalent to this length. Again, this is a 3. So what will happen? This is the equivalent to this one. Then 4, this is equivalent to 4. So those electron having the wavelength 2 lambda only able to occupy the second orbit. So he come to the conclusion that is the quantization of the quantization condition. Quantization means the electrons will present in the discrete energy level. Discrete means step by step, not a continuous energy level. That is the quantization process. So he taken that the circumference of this orbit is equal to n lambda. If n is equal to 1 means first orbit, n is equal to 2 means second orbit. I hope you are clearly understood. So if the lambda is 4 lambda means the electron having the 4 lambda value. How the 4 lambda value? The electrons are revolving in a certain particular orbit with the velocity v, having the mass m. By substituting here we get a lambda value 4 lambda means that electron must be revolving which orbit? Fourth orbit. So that will be equal to, that wavelength is equivalent to circumference of that particular orbit. So according to de Broglie wavelength for nth lambda, nh by mv. So what is the n lambda? Instead of n lambda, we have to substitute 2 pi r. So 2 pi will comes here. Then what will mv will come here, means what will happen? Here mvr, which is equal to nh by 2 pi. Mvr is equal to nh by 2 pi. Mvr is the angular momentum. Which angular momentum? Angular momentum of the free that is electron revolving around the orbit. So the if the angular momentum of the electron is particular value, means that must be equal to nh by 2 pi. That is the statement given by Bohr's postulate, Bohr's condition. So what the Bohr says, that those electron having the angular momentum equal to nh by 2 pi only present in the one that particular orbit. If n is equal to 4 means definitely the angular momentum of the electron must be equal to 4h by 2 pi. If the n is equal to 5 means the 5h by 2 pi is the angular momentum value of the electrons present in all the electrons present in fifth orbit. So are you clear? So that is the thing. So finally the Bohr gives some postulates, that is a Bohr postulate for hydrogen atom. First he says that the nuclear concept. Dear students, are you understand Bohr's quantization condition? So the wavelength must be equal to circumference of the radius. So substituting this circumference of the radius with the de Broglie wavelength, we found that mvr is equal to nh by 2 pi. Mvr is an angular momentum. So finally concluded that the angular momentum of the electron is equal to nh by 2 pi. If n is equal to 1, 2, 3, 4, 5 means we get the angular momentum of the electron in the first orbit, second orbit, third orbit and fourth orbit. Or in other words, those electrons having the this much angular momentum only present in that particular orbit. For example, if you take the fifth orbit or seventh orbit, I take the seventh orbit, n is equal to 7. So 7 h by 2 pi, that is the angular momentum of the electrons present in the seventh orbit of any atom. So the nuclear concept. So this is a Bohr's atom model postulates. What is the nuclear concept? The atom consists of a small and massive central core is called a nucleus, around which a planetary electrons are revolved. That means this is similar to the Rutherford atom model. What is the Rutherford says is correct. The Bohr says that. Bohr says that the Rutherford, that concept, the nuclear concept is exactly correct. The nucleus, all the nucleuses are, all the positive charges are concentrated at the center of the atom only. That particular concentrated point is called nucleus. So the centripetal force required to required for their rotation is provided by electrostatic attraction between electron and nucleus. The electrons are revolving around the nucleus because of the centripetal force, because it is revolving in a circular orbit. For any circular motion, we need the centripetal force. That centripetal force is provided by centrally, that is a present positive charge, and the electron is a negative charge. There will be a force of Coulomb force of attraction between these two. This attraction only provides the centripetal force and makes the electron revolving around the orbit. That is a nuclear concept. Then the second one is, these electrons are revolving around in a particular stationary or stable orbit. That stable orbit angular momentum must be equal to nh by 2 pi. So he says that the electron angular momentum and the orbit angular momentum must be equal. Are those electrons having the orbital angular momentum that only present in that particular orbit? Imagine that if the certain electron having the wavelength of 1.5 things, this will be present only in first orbit, not in the second orbit, because for the second orbit they need the 2 lambda. It has only 1.5 lambda. Definitely it comes down to the lower orbit, that is a 1 lambda, that is the first orbit. If the wavelength is equivalent to 5.5 lambda, so 5.5 lambda is not possible, but that means what is that? The electron will have, we have to take as a 5 lambda. So that will be electrons present in the 5th orbit, not in the 6th orbit. That is just numerically I will explain, just giving the example. Okay. So the angular momentum concept. So that is, that orbit is called a stationary orbit. Now he breaks the limitation, that is the disadvantages of the Rutherford atom model. Whenever the electrons revolving around the nucleus, the energy is lost. That is a statement given in the Rutherford atom model. But here the Bohr says that the electrons are revolving around the nucleus always, but it never loses the energy because it is revolving in a fixed stationary orbit whose angular momentum is equal to nh by 2 pi. So that is a statement given by the Bohr, that is a postulate. Finally, the frequency condition. So he says that if there is a two energy level, E1 and E2, if we want to move the electron from lower orbit to higher orbit, we have to supply the energy. So what will happen? The electron will absorb the energy and it jumps to the higher level, or the electron in the higher energy level will release the energy and comes to the lower level. So we need to supply the energy for pumping, that is shifting the electron from lower energy level to higher energy level. Then the electrons will release the energy when it jumps from the higher level to lower level. That is h nu, the difference in energy, the energy absorbed or energy emitted is equal to E2 minus E1. If you want to move from first energy level to second energy level, we have to give the energy h nu. If the electron jumps from higher energy level to lower level, the energy emitted is h nu. That is, if it is a E3 minus E1, means E3 is a 3 h nu, E1 is a 1 h nu. So what is the difference? It is a 2 h nu energy radiation we have to supply. So that is the things given, statement given by Bohr. Are you clear, students? Because E is equal to n h nu. For first orbit 1 h nu, second orbit 2 h nu, for third orbit it is a 3 h nu. So what is that? What is the energy required to jump the electron from lower orbit to higher orbit? Means subtract. It is a 1 h nu, this is a 3 h nu, 3 h nu minus 1 h nu is a 2 h nu. If you supply the energy of 2 h nu to this electron present in the ground state, it will jump to the third energy level. So that is a statement given by frequency condition. H nu is equal to E2 minus E1. So this equation, that means this session videos is very very important. This concept is very very important. Bohr's quantization condition and Bohr atom model. So read the book pages clearly and understand the concept. So the electrons present in one part, that's why in first orbit only 2 electrons. Then in second orbit 8 electrons, third orbit 18 electrons. We are following the equation 2n squared formula because of the electrons obey, the orbits obeys the L is equal to nh by 2 pi. Electrons momentum and orbital momentum, orbit momentum must be equal to nh by 2 pi by obeying these conditions.